So 21, part 21 na tayo. Okay? So good morning ulit. Tapos na tayo dun sa back pressure, back flow. So alam na natin pati yung mga devices to prevent this kind of pollution, contamination causing installation. So backflow preventer, okay. Device or means to prevent flow of liquid from returning to the source of supply, also called vacuum breaker, okay. So backflow valve, then actually the purpose of using at least 3 plumbing codes, our revised national plumbing code, tapos UPC, tapos meron pang iba, para kasi yung iba hindi naman natin wala doon sa revised national plumbing code. Alam mo yung mga examiner, eh maraming reference yan para makabuo sila ng mga questions, 500, 300 questions. So dapat resourceful tayo, okay? So yan, backflow preventer, a device or means to prevent flow of liquid from returning to the source of supply, also called vacuum breaker. Yan yung isa sa mga device na para to avoid backflow, okay? Back siphonage, the flowing of back of used contaminated or polluted water from the plumbing fixture or vessel into the water supply pipe due to negative pressure in such pipe. Okay, so yung mga devices or method of installation na inaano natin yun, yung air gap, at least meron tayong air gap, or maglalagay tayo ng vacuum breaker para hindi masipon yung wastewater back to the potable water supply, okay? So back water valve, ito yung back water valve, a device installed in a drainage system to prevent reversal of flow, okay? So ito yung back water valve, okay? Back water valve are swing type check valve. Meron ng mga supplier nito in, locally, pero ito ay imported, okay? Think Emerald and Emerald and Moldex, meron sila dito, okay? So to prevent a reversal of flow in the piping and overflows due to stoppage, okay, flooding and other abnormal conditions, okay. So swing type lang yan, parang check valve, okay. Baptistery, ito yung a tank of or pool for baptizing by total immersion. Merong mga tawag dito, merong mga relihiyon na total immersion ang ano nila, pag-baptize ng mga membro nila, baptistery ang tawag, okay? So dito muna tayo sa ano, tulad ng baptistery, eh wala yan sa revised national plumbing code natin, okay? So at least alam din natin yung tawag doon, okay? So back vent pipe, a part of a vent line, okay, which connects directly with an individual trap underneath or behind the fixture and extend to the branch or main vent pipe at any point higher than the fixture or fixture trap it serves. It is sometimes called an individual vent, back venting or individual vent. Kung mapapansin nyo, yung karamihan ng mga designer, lalo na sa mga malaking project, okay, venting ang ano nila, individual vent. Okay? So, yan, tulad yan, back venting. Ang ginagawa nila, back venting, individual venting. So, this is your bathroom group, okay? This is the shower drain, okay? This is your water closet, and this is your emergency floor drain, and this is your lavatory, okay? So, ang back venting or individual vent, so lahat ng fixture, shower drain, floor drain is considered as fixture. So, lahat yan, may individual vent sila or back vent. So yan, individual vent ng shower, water closet, floor drain, then tawag dito yung sa lavatory. Okay, so yan yung individual vent or back vent. Okay, so any part, ulitin ko ha, back vent, any part of a vent line which connects directly with an individual trap. Individual trap, kasi may trap ang shower drain, may trap ang water closet, floor drain, may trap din yan. Kasi as per definition ng vent, at saka yung ano, every trap should be protected against back siphonage and back pressure and back siphonage. Okay, so yun yung kuan, kaya nag-individual vent or back venting ang halos lahat ng mga designer. Okay, so ball cap, valve open and close by a hole and rise respectively of an attached ball floating on the surface of the liquid. So ito yung ang good example, this is yung water closet tank fittings, yung may float, yung may bola doon na pag napuno magko-close, magko-open pag ipinlas mo. So yun yung ball cap. Okay, ball joint, a type of pipe connection in which a ball shape end is held in a capsized shell and allows movement in every direction. So kadalasan na naririnig natin yung ball joint sa mga sasakyan, but a good example of this is yung, alam mo yung sa gasolinahan, yung pang fill ng fuel, yon ball joint yon, kaya kahit saan nila iniikot hindi nabubuhol yung hose. Okay, so bathroom, a room equipped with a shower stall or bathtub. Siyempre, merong ilalagay T&B, yung pala water closet lang ang laman, so walang bath. Okay, so battery of fixture, any two or more similar adjacent fixtures which discharges into a common horizontal soil or waste branch. So similar battery of fixture, so hindi pala matatawag na pagimbawa nakahilera yan, na urinal, water closet, may lavatory, discharging into a common horizontal soil or waste pipe. So hindi pala matatawag na battery of fixture, dapat similar adjacent fixture. Okay, so ito yung ano niyan, yan, battery of fixture. So a group of two or more similar adjacent fixtures. So in this case, for water closet. Okay, so battery fixtures can be battery vented in groups or by up to 8 fixture in accordance with section. Pag-aralan natin yan sa chapter 12 ng this code, is yung vents and venting. So up to 8, pwede mong merong arrangement ng venting dyan na i-share din natin later. Okay, so we have a separate chapter on vents and venting para maano natin, kasi napaka-importante ang vents sa ano lang, So battery fixture, then bell or hub, portion of a pipe which short for a short distance is sufficiently enlarged to receive the end of another pipe of the same diameter for the purpose of making it a caulk or push joint, push on joint. So yon yung hub, alam nyo siguro natin, eh, drawing lang natin ng konti. Okay. So ito yung hub. Yan, tapos to receive either yung caulking, yung stopa dyan, or push on or solvent or type. Yan yung naka-hub siya. Okay, bell or hub. Okay. So bending pin, a tool for strengthening or bending a lead pipe. So bib, synonymous with poset, cap, tap, plug, etc. The word poset is preferred. Okay. Bidet, a plumbing fixture used for washing the middle part of the body, especially the genital, or it is called a sitz bath. Okay. Ito yung panghugas ng ano, alam nyo na, paharap ang upo nito. Okay, paharap ang upo nito, bidet. Plumbing fixture used for washing the middle part of the body, especially the genitals. Oh. Blank plunge, pipe that is not drilled for bolt holes. Okay, so being welded yan. Blind plunge, a plunge that close the end of a pipe. There is no opening for the passage of or liquid or gas. Okay. Blow off, a controlled outlet of a pipeline to discharge liquid or detritus. Okay. Board, the license board of master plumber. Blow off, boiler blow off, a bulb outlet or a boiler that permits discharge of accumulated sediments. Okay. Branch any part of piping system other than the main or riser or stack. Kung riser, it means water supply yan, stack means waste or storm drainage or soil stack. Okay. Branch interval, a length of pipe or waste stack corresponding a general in general to a story height, but not no less than 2.43 meters, within which the horizontal branch from one floor or story of a building are connected. So yan, branch fixture, branch branch, horizontal branch. Okay, so tingnan muna natin doon sa illustrated. Okay. Boiler blow off, an outlet or boiler permits emptying or discharge sediment. Okay, ito yung boiler blow off. Okay, kasi yan, basahin natin ha. A vessel designed to receive the discharge from a boiler blow off outlet or to cool discharge of a temperature to a temperature that permits its safe discharge to the system. Kasi yan, papalalamigin muna. Ito yung blow off, then ito yung blow off tank. So ito yung i-discharge muna dyan, palalamigin, then bago i-discharge sa drain system, kasi bawal yan. Okay, so blow off, bedpan streamer, basahin din natin, wala sa ano natin to. A fixture used for scalding bedpans or urinals by direct application of steam. So sa mga ospital to. Okay, so blow off tanks, a vessel designed to receive discharge from boiler blow off outlet and to cool the discharge to a temperature that permits its safe discharge to the drainage system. So boiler blow off must be cooled to 140 Fahrenheit, degrees Fahrenheit or less, before being discharged into the drainage system. Sa ibang bansa, medyo maano sila dito, mahigpit sila rito. If potable water is supplied for cooling, the water source must be protected from backflow. So yun na yung ano natin, yung mga RPG. Kasi hazard yan, highly hazardous yung mga ano na yan, kind of installation. Air brake can be provided at the discharge from the blow-off tank into the drain system if the make-up water to the boiler is protected against backflow. So air gap, air brake. So kailangan natin yan i-apply sa mga installation natin. So brands, any part of piping other than the riser, main or stack. So this is your waste stack or soil stack. So this is your waste brands. Kung water line naman, water distribution, so this is called the riser, and any other one is called the brands. Okay, water distribution brands. Yon. Okay. So branch horizontal, branch drain, branch interval, yon sinasabi. Distance along a soil or waste stack. Stack means vertical pipe, corresponding in general to a story height, but no less than 8 feet dito. Kasi nga, doon sa amin sa stage, English kami kaya 8 feet. So, ang atin is 2.40 something na meters. Okay? Common brands are used to determine the potential drainage load in stack for the purpose of sizing the soil stack. So, yun yung sinasabi ko na kailangan natin ng schematic diagram para pag nag ano kasi tayo, naglo-loading na tayo to determine the sizes. So, i-ano natin yan. I-label natin yan kung anong load ng bawat branch para makuha natin yung load ng soil stack, di ba? So yun yung ano, branch interval. So hindi pala matatawag na branch to, yung parang mezzanine, less than 4 feet lang. Okay, although hindi sinabi sa atin, bawa may merong intermediate dito, which is A to B are branch interval. B to C and C to D are not branch interval kasi wala sa minimum. Not less than 2.43. Okay? So, building a structure having walls and a roof design and used for housing. So, yun yung building classification. Okay? Arrangement adopted by authorities having jurisdiction for designation of building in classes according to occupancy. So, building classification, minimum number of required plumbing fixture includes assembly, business. So, yun yung mga building classification. Tapos, later, we will study or share to you the minimum number of required plumbing fixtures depending on the occupancy. That is the most neglected provision in our code. Sa isang floor sa school, kailangan pala ng isang drinking fountain, wala nang nilalagay. So, ang isang mall, kailangan ganito karami ang water closet depending on the population, estimated population, male or female, hindi naman nasusunod kasi ayaw ng owner na dumami yung malaki ang space na kinukuha doon sa plumbing utilities. So, yun yung talagang hindi, the most neglected part of our plumbing code na dapat alam din ng mga architects yan. Okay? So, yun. Dito na muna tayo para hindi masyadong mahaba yung part na to, part 21. So, just subscribe, follow. Okay? So, yung ano natin, tawag dito, baka mabor kayo. Ito kasing lecture na ito is not only intended for yung mga nagdi-lisensyado na or nagdi-design na. This is also intended for yung gustong kumuha pa ng exam at saka gustong ma-repress yung mga lisensyado na gustong ma-repress yung theory nila. Okay? Kasi baka nakalimutan na. Okay. So, thank you.